Hello and welcome everybody. So in this section we take a bit lighter approach. We did a lot of theoretical work in the previous two sections, and here I just want to do a series of examples to make sure we can apply all of these techniques we have learned. So we start with one of the more basic ones, namely a confidence interval for a single regression coefficient. So let's see how we do that. Okay, so let us first remind how to compute a confidence interval. So that's in section 5, individual regression coefficients, and then 5.2 confidence intervals. And here, lemma 5.3 is the result we need. It says this thing, which we will need to remember what it means, is a 1 minus alpha confidence interval for coefficient beta I. So let's try that. The data set I want to choose here is from what's called the UCI Machine Learning Repository. That is a webpage which has a collection of data sets, and if you need data for an example, that's one of the places you can go to. So there are 588, and we want to do regression. We currently deal with numerical data. I would say multivariate is probably the right type of data. And let's say less than 10 attributes. We don't want p too large. And I don't know, let's take a slightly larger problem. Let's take this one. And there are very many. You see, some of them are quite old. Here's one from 1987, but some of them are newer. So what I decided to do here is to take one of these two. I'm not quite sure why they are two, and they differ in number of samples and number of variables. Let's take this one. So for our purpose, that is not so important here what that means, because again, we are just trying to learn about linear regression. But if you want to know more about this data set, here is a paper where the data is used. Here, well, there are names for the columns, and here are a few explanations, even if I have to say not all of them make sense to me. But one keyword is here, number 9 is the response. So we will just do linear regression, taking number 9 as the response and 1 to 8 as the inputs. So let's try that. Data folder is here. Here is the data set. Copy link address. Good, let's load that into R. So not quite sure what I did. Let's break that down. URL is this one. That's the address. That still worked, and then I do read CSV URL, which now fits, does something. So we have loaded the data set. We do some checking. That has gone wrong. There is only one row with that rather complicated looking name. I can spot this here. Columns are separated by semicolons, obviously. So let's try that. That is better. Now we have the required number of columns, but still the columns here have funny names. And what has happened here is the first row contained the number 2.419, and read.csv tried to read column names from the first row, and it said that was no proper name, so it added an X to make it start with a letter. But what we need to do is the data obviously does not start with column names, so we do header is false. Let's do that. Now we are good. Now we have no longer descriptive names, because we said there is no header, so it just shows V1 up to V9. And they are all either numeric or integer valued, so that looks very good, I think. Let's look at the first few rows. That looks fine to me. Okay, let's assume we have imported the data correctly. Now, on the web page, here it tells us names for the columns. I will just pop them onto the columns, even if we will not make use of any interpretation. Yeah, that should do the job. Let's try that. So now if I do head QSAR, now we have columns, and LC50 is the one we said we would use for a response. So let's fit a linear model, LC50 as a function of the others. Data is in QSAR. Good. So here are our estimates for the coefficients and some extra information, some of which we have discussed. So let's see, how do we get a confidence interval? Well, we first need to settle on a coefficient. Which one shall we use? I think let's use that one, just randomly. So that is number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, I think, and with the intercept 7. So hat beta I is coefficients of m, that's the beta hat I, and then I set the 7s. Let's see whether that checks out. So hat beta I, yes, it says here gut as 1p, whatever this means, and minus 0.571, which was the estimated value here. Good, now that's the centers of the interval, and now we need to get, well, all of this really. Let's do the sigma hat squared first. The sigma hat squared we can get out from here. So I think I found out that we can do it like summary m, which gives us an object which prints as this table, but if we do sigma here, then we get the estimated standard deviation for the errors. And here we can see hat sigma, it's 1.202. That's that. Good, then we need CII. For that we need the design matrix, data matrix M, and then C is X transpose times X inverse. And then we need row 7, column 7, so that would be CII. This one, and then we need this quantile of the T distribution, so N and P we need to find. So N is N row X, P is N col X, and I subtract 1 for the intercept. And the quantile then is, we need 1 minus alpha over 2, so we need 0.975 if I do it at 5% levels with N minus P minus 1 degrees of freedom. Ah, because I typed the wrong command here and I should have used model matrix. Now it worked, I think. That looks like a reasonable critical value. It's close to the 1.96, which we would have for a normal distribution, which makes sense since n is 546. Now, the confidence interval is the midpoint, so hat beta I, minus square root of hat sigma squared. Ah, okay, we have the square root already, so that can go here. Then square root CII times T. And then the same thing with the plus gives the upper bound. Let's try that. So that says between minus 0.87 and minus 0.26, where again the estimated coefficient was minus 0.57. So that makes all sense, because minus 0.57 is in the interval and it seems to have a reasonable width. Good, so that is one way of doing it. What I really would do is most of the quantities we can get from here, so we can get the lower bound also as this number here, minus that number times t, and then again the mean here plus standard error times t, and that should give the same result, because this number here is the square root of sigma hat squared times CII, so that's the thing we computed by hand before. So the by hand method gives this, and the method of reading it off the LM output gives the same numeric values. Good, so that's how we do a confidence interval for a single coefficient.